What's happening? Welcome to yet another vlog, and once more I'm joined here tonight by...
Hello.
Isco's right here. You've seen him in various previous vlogs, and today we picked a very exciting place to shoot the sunset from. That's right here, the rooftop at One New Change, which overlooks the beautiful St. Paul's Cathedral. And there's actually various compositions you can achieve from this very rooftop, which is why it's pretty awesome because you've got so much diversity. Another great shot you can get from here is this one back here, the shard. And if you bring a really long lens, like a telephoto lens, back here in the distance, down here, is even the London Eye. So, a lot of diversity, a lot of good photos to be taken, and the conditions couldn't be any more perfect right now. Check this out. Mid-sunset glow, got that tasty orange lighting up the sky, and that's just awesome. So, let me show you some of the photos we've been taking right now. We'll be focusing on the wide-angle shots. Camera on the tripod, there it is. Because it's already pretty dark right now, so it's good to have the camera on a tripod, which allows for slower shutter speeds while maintaining your base ISO, ISO 100 in this case, just to maintain that perfect quality. Because if you raise your ISO and keep the shutter speed fast, your pictures end up very grainy and you lose quality. So always good to use a tripod, lowest ISO possible, and keep that shutter speed as slow as it needs to be. So check these photos out. So sunset has turned to blue hour, and this is the view I wanted to show you guys earlier, but it was difficult to see. And that's all the way back here. All the way back there, this little red circle over here is the London Eye, and that's really, really far away. So in order to get this shot, I'm using a beast of a lens, 70-200 lens by Canon, which is absolutely one of my favorite lenses ever. I don't even own it. I had to borrow Isco's. Thanks for letting me borrow it. It's a beautiful telephoto lens, which obviously lets you bring in subjects that are really far, very close, but it's even very, very good for portraits because you can really get a lot of background blur with that f2.8 aperture, which I'm not using right now. Stepped the lens down quite a bit just to retain more sharpness throughout the whole image. But yeah, it's just a very versatile lens, an absolute favorite amongst professional photographers. And let me show you what this lens can do. So, like I said, London Eye is all the way back here, and let me show you what this looks like at 200 millimeters. Check it out. Right at the bottom on the ground level, and that's this right here. This passageway is just beautifully designed, and the architecture is absolutely stunning. They really thought this one through, because check this out. You've got the reflections of St. Paul's Cathedral behind me on either sides of these shop windows, just reflecting perfectly, letting you see the cathedral of St. Paul's Cathedral. The dome you can see three times, once the main view, and then twice mirrored on either side into those glass windows. And that's just the perfect composition. And it's an absolute London classic if you know this secret hidden spots right here in London. So I'll show you guys how I went about taking this photo. Since this is a night photo, a tripod is absolutely key. I'm going for shutter speeds of about 15 seconds just to get enough exposure to expose the cathedral and the night perfectly. And there's no other way to do that and to get you a stable shot without using a tripod. So that's the composition. Another thing I wanted to point out is that I've got the tripod fairly low right now. It's set up to be quite close to the floor because that gives you a very dramatic view. Because you've got accentuating the foreground right here, and I'm using this gutter right here at the bottom as a leading line that just leads you up beautifully all the way into the distance with the cathedral in the background. So that's the composition in a nutshell, but let's go take a look at the final photo. Last final photo of the evening, we thought we'd do some night photography, and it's really one of the most perfect places to do that. It's just outside St. Paul's Cathedral. You because when it comes to night photography, and we're doing some light trails, by the way, which means long exposures with buses whooshing past us behind us, creating these amazing trails of light. Now, the trails of light are cool in themselves, but they do need a strong foreground and a strong background element to give the whole scene a lot of context and just complete the overall picture. Now, I thought in order to do this, the best place to come would be right here. And the foreground element is going to be this phone box, which is obviously extremely iconic London. And then the other landmark, of course, St. Paul's Cathedral. You can never go wrong with that shot in the background as well. Now, if you're wondering, by the way, why this telephone cab is black and not red like all the other ones, it has a very specific reason. And back in the day, every different company offering these phone boxes had their own unique brand and their own unique color, hence. And while most of them are red, which is the main company, there's also a different company which had black boxes. Now, as you can tell, there's some buses whooshing past us, and that's exactly what we've been trying to capture the whole time. If you time your shot right, 20-second shutter speed, you turn that bus into an amazing whooshing light trail. And I took this one step further and thought, heck, as if the phone box and St. Paul's Cathedral wasn't enough, I thought, why not do a self-portrait while I'm at it, hit the timer on the camera, and just get involved, strike a pose, wait for the whole action to unfold, and then walk away with an amazing photo. And that's exactly what I managed to do. Here it is, check it out. That's all I have to show you guys tonight. I thought it's been an amazing evening. I walked away with some incredible shots, and I hope you learned something about where the best locations are in London to photograph St. Paul's Cathedral. One New Change Shopping Centre, an absolute must, as well as just outside the cathedral itself. Come for sunset, stay for the night, and walk away with some incredible shots. Now that's it from me, and I have one plea to you guys. I'd love to grow this channel and this community right here together with you. So if you haven't already, I'd appreciate it if you hit that subscribe button below, and you won't be missing out on future videos. And one other thing, if you drop a like and a comment, that does make this channel grow, because YouTube uses an algorithm, it's boring, whatever. Just show some love, and this video will get seen by a lot more people and help me grow this channel as well. Thanks for your help, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. Bye for now.